NICC, admitted to the Department of Interior Decorations and Design. I have this innate ability in me of creativity and innovation. The financial crisis have been my downfall. But I thank God for my honorable that came up with this idea to help me to dish out the innate ability in me. When I came into this place this evening, I saw this court and I said, wow, this is my department, interior design and decoration. How I wish this meeting was not just an emergency meeting. I think we would have done something better off than this. And I believe, sir, by God's special grace, the next gathering, this place is not going to be like this. There are going to be more decorations and designs. And more also, interior decorations and designs involved, I thought it's just all about colors, missing of colors. But when I came into this place, I discovered that it involves many areas like tailoring, rendering, to make somebody feel. And with this, I also discovered that they taught us a subject called entrepreneurial development, which talks about innovation, creativity, and how to relate to your clients and to your customers. With the knowledge derived from this place, I believe that we'll have a better tomorrow. And I believe that we are not only just a student of NICC, but we are already employers of labor. My honorable sir, may God bless you for your unending effort and support. Thank you, sir.
Well, I am my name, Ehizoba Ernest. I am a student of this institution. I am in the Department of Production and Development of Machine Parts. So, let me start by commending our able rector for the conducive learning environment. Everything well organized and arranged. We were given a course outline. We have workshop, safety in workshop. We also have measurement, measuring to precision. We also have engineering drawing, freehand sketching. We also have identification of machines in the workshop. So the theoretical aspect was perfect indeed. So I went through a higher institution before. I'm a first degree holder in materials and production engineering. So this, I can tell you that the system I saw here is different from the system I went through before. I commend you, Prof. So on the practical aspect, so we're given opportunity to get into a workshop. So at a workshop, we also teach identification of machine where we have series of different types of welding machine. We have the MIG machine, we have the electrical arc machine, and we have the oxyacetylene machine. They are in the workshop there. So we started with the electrical arc welding, joining of metals together. And I swear to tell you that the gentleman who is training us there is a perfect man indeed, who teach us with patience to make sure that we grab everything that he is teaching there. So I was thinking that I cannot join two metal together. So this gentleman teach us how to cut metal and bring it together. So I can as well tell you today, I cannot say I'm a perfect welder for now, but I can join two metal together perfectly. Just the way I have seen others doing it on the roadside. But I went out to inquire from the local welders on the street. So in terms of measuring the precision, I think what we are learning here is different from what they are doing. I commend the man at the workshop, welding and fabrication workshop. This is the first time we are seeing ordinary men children getting benefits, dividends of democracy. For if I would have used another word, just because you were swelling, because we know that before you started this program, the Nigerian government has never paid you any salary before you started this program. This morning, we are coming to your own program. So I really, indeed, thank you, sir.
There's something I've written here. He said, the place of skill acquisition cannot be provided besides in the rapid development of other sectors for the economy. For this to be actualized, proper skill acquisition policies and goals must be put in place and well implemented. Listening to Engineer Professor talking about the meeting with the federal government and the directive, I think we are ahead of time. Then we send a message to them that we are ahead of time. Come here and see what is going on. What do you think?
Thank you. This set up this institution, like we have already said, the federal government will set up institutions around but do not do enough of monitoring. Now that is the presidential directive, that's the word we use these days. Now that is the presidential directive, the people will urge them to come and see the great men and women that we have imparted knowledge on and are available to cause the desired change in this country. I know we are very industrious people, the Asian people. Then we cannot narrow it down to our Basilo. We are very industrious and enterprising. All we need is just a little assistance or direction, which by the grace of God, some of us are willing to do. The greatest set of minds you can invest in are the young ones. Load them with enough information, they will change the world. I remember some years ago, I think last week was my 18th year anniversary in marriage. And I remember with something we do in church. The things we used to do before I got born again was Bachelor's Eve. But in church, what we do is testimony night. So my church, my wife belongs to a fellowship, and then I belong to a fellowship in church. So they were going to have something for us, both fellowships. The hall we were to use, because of the people that turned up, the hall was not too small. So we went to negotiate with the manager of the club, NMPC complex in Warren. So he gave us a bigger hall to use. Because that hall was not dressed, the minute we came out from negotiating with the manager, and we told him the big hall was available, in less than 5 minutes, I don't know how many people know the NNPC General Staff Complex in Benelese Warren. It is about 5 times the size of this hall, or even 10 times the size of this hall. I am not exaggerating, in 5 minutes, the young people arranged those chairs. They were throwing the chairs, they would catch and arrange in 5 minutes. What caught my attention that day was this set of people, the way they have arranged this hall. If you tell them, give the negative information to them to destroy it, in 2 minutes they will destroy it. So why don't we tap the energy in these young ones and then sit back and see what they will do? So that is the driving force. The young mind is so imaginative. So program me to the right information and the rest will be history. So as long as I have breath in my lung, I will always support the young ones. So my prayer, I will pray to God and beg you, never give up on your dream. When you dream, wake up and go and actualize the dream. Don't go back and sleep again. Get up, actualize the dream. The world will become too small for you. If you can dream it, you will see it, and you will take the world, and the world will celebrate you.